about to say.
Go ahead.
Once Big Brother has spoken, you will have the opportunity to respond. Do you understand?
Yes.
Before you entered the Big Brother house, you were reminded of the rules regarding unacceptable language and behaviour. At 14:07 today, you were involved in an argument with Shree. During this argument, Big Brother called you to the diary room. Big Brother told you that Big Brother felt that this language, in that context, that you used could have been interpreted as threatening. Big Brother also reminded you that Big Brother will not tolerate threatening language in the Big Brother house. Further to this conversation with you in the diary room, Big Brother has spent significant time reviewing the argument between you and Shree in the garden today. The argument between you and Shree went as follows. Shree, what's your language? What's your language? What's your language? Marcus, why don't you make me? Why don't you make me? Why don't you make me? Further to this, Shree said, what's your actions? Thank you, Marcus. I have no time for this. Don't put the finger in my face. It's bad. You said, what's my finger in your face? I'll tell you what, Shree. Tell you what. Shut up. Shut up. And when we get outside, then say it then. Say it when we're outside. Don't say a single more thing when we're in here. Let's see if you're so brave. Let's see if you're so brave outside. Whilst Big Brother accepts that housemates will not necessarily get on in the Big Brother house and that arguments are inevitable, Big Brother will not tolerate the use of language that could be deemed to be threatening. Marcus, Big Brother is in no doubt that your language was threatening. As such, Big Brother is left with no choice other than to issue you with a formal warning. Any further use of language or behaviour that Big Brother deems to be unacceptable may lead to you being removed from the Big Brother house. Do you understand?
Yes.
Big Brother would like to make a distinction between two incidents that happened today. Earlier today, you and Shree had an argument whilst doing the shopping list. Big Brother spoke to you about the language that was used in that conversation. But in that conversation with you, Marcus, Big Brother was merely reminding you of the rules regarding using people's cultural background in a derogatory manner. The formal warning relates to the argument you had with Shree in the garden, not the argument you had when you were doing the shopping list.
Okay, right, well, accepted then. We'll leave all of the shopping list aside.
Marcus, is there anything that you would like to say?
Yeah, you're talking shit. That's double standards and complete wank. That's complete wank. I was sitting there, I was the recipient of him. What? Seriously, what are you talking about? If somebody gets out of a chair, if I get out of a chair now and I come up to your camera and go, like that, that is not as aggressive as just sitting there, minding your own business, saying to someone, you know, if you're going to do something, then don't just talk about it, you do it. How is that? You're just talking absolute bollocks. I'm sorry, but think about it. Think about the words I'm saying. Are we talking in different languages? I get up like this, I come up to you, like that, and someone just sitting down like that and going, all right then, do whatever. Go on, make me. Like that. The only reason you're saying that is because I'm bigger than him, and that's almost like a race thing or an ageist thing or a sexist thing. That's absolute bollocks.
Marcus, your age, race and size has nothing to do with this.
Bollocks, age, size definitely does.
Earlier today, you said to Shree, and I quote, and when we get outside, then say it then. Say it when we're outside. Don't say a single more thing when we're in here. Let's see if you're so brave. Let's see if you're so brave outside.
Yeah, exactly.
Big Brother is in no doubt that this language is threatening.
No, see, that's you trying to second-guess what I'm thinking. I've explained to you what exactly was going through my mind when I said that. When I said to him, if he's outside, he's not going to say a single thing. Now, I haven't got a single thing in the world to gain by smacking around a little piss ant like that. Like I said to other people, I could kill him, really honestly kill him, with my eyebrow if I wanted to. There's a million billion people out there who need a smack. I've never hit anyone like that in my entire life, and I probably never will. I've got nothing to gain, even by acknowledging his existence outside this house. He has to come in here, and you have to watch it like that, and play his little game, because he's in it fucking hours and hours a day, bloody crying and pissing in his pants about anything that he can just get a bit of sympathy about, and it's obviously worked. So shame on you for falling for his absolute, stupid, pathetic, transparent little plans just to come in here and just make us all look like absolute idiots, because that's what he's doing, and you're falling for it, and it's just offensive, and it's just spoiling every single thing that your show's supposed to stand for. So you need to grow a pair and get him in here and say, look, it's not all about you, you little fucker. There are rules in this place, you know what I mean? And make a fucking precedent, and then hopefully people watching can actually get something positive from it instead of always fawning to little pissant wankers like that, spoiling every single thing that society, like, has good going for it.
Marcus, Big Brother treats all housemates equally.
Bollocks. Absolute bollocks, and this is proof of it.
Marcus, Big Brother's decision is final. The diary room door is now open.